everybody. I've been getting quite a few messages asking me how I maintain Sophie's tear stains and how I make them look less noticeable. Sophie has had tear stains since the very first day I brought her home, so I've had a whole year trying to figure out what works best in order to make sure that those tear stains don't get very noticeable, very big, and crusty. I want to share with you the one easy thing that I do every day, and I think that this helps keep those tear stains away, but I also really want to show you guys how I trim the hair around her eyes. I think that's honestly the biggest thing that has the biggest impact on making sure those tear stains don't have anywhere to develop and settle into her fur. For this video, I actually let her tear stains grow out a little bit just so that I can show you guys what they look like and how I trim them. I usually do this about every week on Sundays, so let's get to it. One easy thing that I do every day is I make sure that her ceramic bowl is clean and always filled with filtered water. There's also been research that shows that filtered water is a better option for puppies who have tear stains or have a tendency to develop tear stains. So I always make sure that she has filtered water as well, not anything from the tap. And then I just make sure that I wash her bowls every single night so that she always has clean bowls to eat and drink out of and there's no lingering bacteria or any germs from the day before. Now let me show you how I trim Sophie's eye hair and also how I just clean the area and everything like that. When it comes to trimming her eye hair, I use three things. I use her slicker brush, I use a tiny pair of scissors, and then I always have a very soft washcloth that's wet with warm water as well. Now the key for cutting tear stains is all about the angle, and I'm going to show you what I mean. Okay, and I just want to show you guys what the stains look like right now. So they've developed a little bit. You can see that little deposit down there and everything like that. And they've gotten quite thick, so I'm going to show you guys how I cut them. I take advantage of whenever she's feeling sleepy or she's lying down to cut her. And if you can tell, she's tilted more on her left side. So when she's tilted on her left, I cut her right because then I can put her head down gently and cut her right. Okay, so I will have to hold her usually, but I just come in with the scissors.
Good girl!
And I just cut it right out. So there's that nice thick chunk of eye crust. Now if you look now, she's looking a little bit cleaner. I might still do a little bit more because she's still got that little redness there.
Good girl.
And that's how you know you've gotten the tear stains. You've gotten a lot darker hair than what was originally there. And if you can see on Sophie, there's no more redness there. There's a little bit poking out there on top, but I'm not going to cut that because that's too close.
That's the right side done.
And I have to convince her to lie down on this side. Sophie, come here. This side too has gotten some darker stains. I'm just going to come in here.
Good girl.
So we got a little bit. Got a little bit. There's still some in there. So if you want to see. So I don't know if you can see, there's still a little bit more in there.
Oh, good girl.
And then after I've cut her crust and her hair, her dark hair, I like to just pass the wet cloth on top.
There you go, good girl.
And sometimes you'll get any extra crusty sogginess out of there. And then after I'm done cutting her crust and cleaning out any little bits that she may have left behind with the cloth, I'll just go and do a little quick comb over. I know, good girl. And make sure that I've gotten everything. And then look, voila. Let me bring you a little closer. Look at that. No more tear stains. And you can see the area where they're going to continue to develop again because there is still a little bit of redness right up here in the center of her eye. But that's okay. We'll clean them again next time. But basically, that's all I do. I just need to stay on top of these weekly trimmings. I do it every Sunday. Sophie is totally used to it now. I know everybody has different strategies, so you got to find what works best for you. So it's just something that really works for us, and it's just a really great way to make sure those tear stains don't have a chance to develop. I really hope that this video answers your questions on how I maintain these tear stains. Thanks so much for watching, and please don't forget to subscribe so you can see more. Bye for now, guys. Say bye, Sophie. Bye, guys.